Hi folks, Peach Mario again with the second video about how can we improve the community communication. And the first thing should be, let's say, a proof of concept how a new tilwiki.org or something page could look like. So yeah, this is a proof of concept, which is the main page. This landing page is manually created, but yeah, there is also some automatically created stuff which uses Tilwiki and Tilwiki build process to create a static web page. Okay, how does it look like? There is, on the top left, there is a link which goes back to the page. There is a little bit of a menu. There is the main area which talks a little bit about the project. Then there is a getting started button which does nothing at the moment, it just jumps to the page. Then there is an area which talks a little bit about Tilwiki features. I'm using them to also show the workflow afterwards, how to create feature requests. And there is some information about different pages, or let's say different languages, language documentations. And this page is already automatically created because I made a prototype some time ago already. So where all the content are different tiddlers and the layout is a template, and Tilwiki can create a static page with the different tiddler contents. So it looks like this, relatively simple. But yeah, as a starting point, it should give you an overview how I think it can look like. Then there is some call to action at the moment which does nothing. What did I use to create the static page? It's a project which is called purecss.io, which is a very basic CSS framework which has absolutely no JavaScript involved. And that's something that I wanted to have. There are different layout types. So there is the landing page, there is prototypes for a photo gallery which we can use, and there is something which is called a blog. And that one I used to display the different languages. And it can even be used to create something like email layout, if we would like to create our own email client, pricing table, and so on. There is also one important thing: the whole element is responsive. So if we use, let's say, mobile phones, then it works out of the box. So we go to the landing pages and so on. So everything is mobile friendly. Yeah, that's the first part, how a landing page can look like. And I think before I go on, I switch off the video recording so I have shorter videos. So the next one will be feature requests. See you soon.